English words than the English dialect. One more time for Niall.
One room. It's sort of nothing. Can I talk to the living room quick? That band that just came up here?
Yeah!
How old are you?
13?
When I was 13, I couldn't even get three friends to play rock band with me. An actual rock band. That's nuts. But I want to tell you guys, like, every single person in this room that has talent, you are definitely, like, everyone I've seen has that passion, that look in their eye. Y'all are definitely going places, so get used to this, because you guys look like you have a great time, it's going to get even more. So, who here has written the studio tour at Universal Studios before? Universal Hollywood.
Yeah.
Alright, so, what I will be doing in a matter of days is being that guy desperately trying to make you guys laugh for about 45 minutes to an hour while looking at stuff. So that's why I took it upon myself to come up here and try my best to entertain you guys. And it's either going to go one of two ways. That's normally how it goes, right? You either get, you know, it goes great, or you learn the hard way. Unfortunately, every single thing I've ever done, I've learned the hard way. And that's just sometimes what you gotta do. I always say, like, I'm the kid who had to touch the hot iron twice to learn that it hurts. And that is a true story. Honest to God, it is. I'm the kid that had to learn that just because you have Superman pajamas on, you can't dive off your bunk bed and expect a sword of greatness. Because that too does not happen. There's so many things down the road that you look at where you can go. You can go this way, which is the smart and very well thought out, very prepared way, and the way I saw fit to go for the rest of my life. And it does take you in crazy places, absolutely. Like, I moved to LA a couple months ago, the very first time. Has anybody seen La La Land here?
Yeah!
If you guys remember that line in the song, that a nickel to my name, hop the bus, here I came, could be brave or just insane. Pretty sure it was safe to say that I was insane 4 months ago, because it did not work out very well. But that's part of the whole learning experience, right?
Right.
You know, and every single time you do something, you gotta ask yourself, like, will this make a good story? Like, I remember one time I went to this pet zoo. It was a snake farm, but there was a bunch of other animals, so I think the snakes were just greedy with that one. But I went in there, there's this petting zoo I was playing around with, me and my mom. We're having a great time, right? Petting animals, having fun. I go inside for a second, and I come back, and the first thing I see is this escaped llama in the doorway eating this tree in front of me. And immediately I knew that this was going to be an interesting situation. And I look slightly to the left of the llama's neck, and my mother is sprinting after a family of chickens and saying, "I'm sorry I let you out, but please come back." Now, I'm saying a nice day out to the petting zoo is turning into my first time having to wrangle animals. So we're both running around and just trying our best to get everything under control. Get the situation, get the goats in there, little turtles there for some reason, weren't too hard to catch, thank God. I saw this chicken that locked eyes with me, and I knew something was wrong because I just had KFC on my head. And he's staring at me, and I'm sure it's not a friendly stare, not at all. And I take one step, you know, the friend is like, "Hey, it's okay," and he charges me. And at this point, so I'm like 15 years old, Bill New Braunfels, Texas, screaming at the top of his lungs, getting chased by a chicken. And the only thing I can think to myself is, oh my God, will this make a great story one day? And that's just, you know, anytime you're in a bad situation, you gotta think that. Will it make a great story? Will my pain bring others suffering? And then, that's how you know it's actually worth it there. Now, I'm not a musician, I don't play any instruments, trust me, I've tried, sports are a pathetic failure, but there are two things that I am supposed to be good at as a director, that's making movies and talking. Well, thank God those are the only two things I am good at, so that's what will get me through the rest, you know? Figure out what you have in your arsenal, keep using that, no matter how many hilariously dumb situations that happen, you know. Hot light bulb falls on your face, and then you're known as the person in the family who kissed the light bulb. You know? You get past those things. The person who jumped off the bunk bed, the person who stared his grandfather in the eyes and said, "Papa, what was it like when the world turned to color?" I'll never forget the face. He did not believe it at first, just cocked his head a little bit, like, "What?" I was like, "Oh, you know, when it life switched from black and white to color. Were you outside? What was your favorite one? You know, he never really responded, but I figured it out. the correct response to that one. But yeah, that's about all I have to say for this one. But thank you guys so much for coming out.
Stand up and see.
Exactly.
That was Lyle with words.